Let's say you want to make some pizzas. Your recipe for pizza requires one crust, 8 ounces of pizza sauce, and 4 cups of cheese. You have 5 crusts, 24 ounces of pizza sauce, and 16 cups of cheese. How many pizzas can you make from these ingredients? If you said 3 pizzas, you intuitively understand the idea of limiting reagent. We can solve this problem using dimensional analysis by converting our amounts of each reactant into amount of product. We have 5 pizza crusts, and each pizza requires 1 pizza crust, so we have enough crust to make 5 pizzas. We have 24 ounces of pizza sauce, and each pizza requires 8 ounces of sauce, so we have enough sauce for 3 pizzas. And we have 16 cups of cheese, and each pizza requires 4 cups of cheese, so we have enough cheese for 4 pizzas. Since we can create the fewest number of pizzas from the pizza sauce, this ingredient limits the amount of pizza we can theoretically make. In the previous problem, pizza sauce was our limiting reactant or limiting reagent. The limiting reagent produces the least amount of product, thus limiting how much product can be produced. Pizza crusts and pizza sauce were our excess reagents or excess reactants. Excess reactants are all of the reactants that have some left over after reacting completely with a limiting reagent. And in our problem, 3 pizzas was our theoretical yield, which is the amount of product we can produce based on our limiting reagent. We can calculate how much excess reactant is left over based on our theoretical yield. We calculated previously that we should be able to produce 3 pizzas based on our limiting reagent, pizza sauce. So we can calculate how much of our excess reagents are required to produce 3 pizzas. We'll need 3 crusts to produce 3 pizzas. We started with 5 crusts, and we'll use 3 crusts to produce those 3 pizzas, so we should have 2 crusts left over. We'll also need 12 cups of cheese to produce 3 pizzas. We started with 16 cups of cheese, and we used 12 cups of cheese to produce our 3 pizzas, so we should have 4 cups of cheese left over. When you actually run an experiment, you may get out a different amount of product than you calculated you should be able to produce. The amount of product you actually produce when you perform an experiment is called the actual yield. The percent yield is the actual yield divided by the theoretical yield times 100%. So let's say when you tried to create your pizza from the recipe, you actually produce 2 pizzas. Let's calculate the percent yield. Our equation for percent yield is actual yield divided by theoretical yield times 100%. We calculated the theoretical yield based on our limiting reagent. Our theoretical yield is 3 pizzas. We're given the actual yield in the problem, which is 2 pizzas. Plugging these into our equation and completing the calculation, we get 66.7%. This is our percent yield.